Hello there, I am Amay Chikkerli, a final year student from IT department at Walson Institute of Technology. Today, we are going to perform a virtual lab at IIT Hyderabad under Cryptography Lab, and the topic name is Digital Signature Scheme. So, introduction. A digital signature is an authentication mechanism that enables the creator of the message to attack a code that acts as a signature. The signature is formed by taking the hash of the message and encrypting the message with the creator's private key. The signature guarantees the authenticity, integrity, and non-repudiation of the message. So, in this experiment, we are going to learn how digital signatures are generated. And we are going to generate our own digital signature using this virtual lab. So, in digital signatures, there are two ends, that is the sender and the receiver. The sender generates the signature and receiver verifies the signature. So, initially, the message or the data is passed to the hash function, and the hash function creates the message digest. To generate the signature, we need a private key and the message digest, and we generate a signature, and this signature is passed to the receiver, and the receiver verifies the signature, and if the signature is valid, then we guarantee that this message is authentic. So here Alice is the sender and Bob is the receiver. So R is the random secret and P is the public key that is required to generate an authentic signature S1. So using this F1 function, we generate an authentic signature, that is S1. So now we take a hash of the message, a private key, a random secret that we use to generate S1, and the S1 signature itself to generate another signature, that is S2. Now at the receiver end, we are going to verify the signature. For that, we take input as signature 1, signature 2, public key, and hash of the message that we are going to send. So function 3, we verify the output with F1. If the output is equal to S1, then we accept the message. Now Alice has to generate public key and private key, and public key has to be announced by Alice to the receiver. So to generate these keys, we choose a prime number between 512 and 124 bits of length. The number of bits P must be multiple of 64. We choose a 160 bit prime Q in such a way that Q divides P minus 1. Choose a primitive root E of 0 in ZP. Create E1 such that E1 is equals to E of O into P minus 1 divided by Q mod of P. Choose D as a private key and calculate E2 is equal to E1 into D. Now we have public key as E1, E2, P and Q, and private key as D. This public key is given to the receiver. And now to generate signature S1, we take public key and the random secret. And to generate signature 1, E1 into R mod P mod of Q. Now to generate signature S2, we take private key, public key, hash of the message, actual message, that is M, and we generate S2. The equation is hash of message M plus D power S1 into R minus 1 mod Q. Now we have signature S1 and S2. At the receiver end, that is Bob, we have to verify the message. So we have to verify the message with S1. So to verify, we take input S1, S2, public key, hash of the message, and the verification function is E1 into hash of M, that is actual message, into S2 minus 1 power E2 into S1 into S2 minus 1 mod of P mod of Q. So if S1 is equals to V, Then we accept this message and the signature is verified. So these are the steps required to complete this virtual lab. Enter the input text to encrypt in the plain text area and generate a hash value of the message by clicking on the S1. So this is our input text M that we are going to hash. So this is the hash of our message. Copy the content of hash output field and paste in the input of RSA field. Select key size of public key from RSA public selection by clicking on any key button. And we are going to apply RSA button and generate our digital signature. This is the hash output of our message. We are going to paste it here. Now we are going to generate our digital signature using one of the four methods. So by applying this public key, we are going to generate our digital signature in hex and in base 64. So this is the hex of our digital signature and this is base 64 of our digital signature. Digital signature cannot provide hash for the message. As we have learned earlier, digital signature can provide integrity, non-repudiation, and authentication. So the answer is confidentiality. Digital signature uses hash to generate a valid signature. That is secret key. Verification algorithm uses public key for validation digital signature. Now we consider Alice as a sender and Bob as a receiver. So Bob must have public key generated by the Alice.